and let it absorb into other energies and get it out of my life. So when I had negative people in my life, I would use a black candle and I wouldn't be very specific in my desires. I'm not trying to banish the person. You can't do that anyway. You can't banish a person. You can make a person sick maybe, but you cannot do that, because what you're saying when you try to banish a person, you're basically saying that you, that person does not exist, that soul does not exist, and that's not true. But banishing, I banished the relationship, maybe. So I do that. And I also use a white candle, because I don't like to just use black. I want to, I would say if I was going to want to banish a relationship, or banish a bad habit, banish something out of my life that I don't desire, I would use a black candle, and I'd also kind of counter it with a white candle. White candle is giving off. Now I want to imagine the things I would give off in place of this. You don't want to just take the energy away, you want to replace it with something that you desire. I want to get rid of a bad relationship. I want to replace it with relationships in my life that are positive. I want to get rid of my bad habit of smoking. I'm going to replace it with a good habit, maybe, of eating healthy foods. You're taking the bad energy out, you're bringing the positive energy in, and that's what you want to do. I would not ever suggest meditating to a black candle. If your meditation is very advanced, you will find out that you are beginning to have your energy drained. You will begin to feel very fatigued, irritable, just, it's not a good candle to use. And also, on the same token, I have to tell you that I'm very careful just meditating to violet. Violet is a very wise color. That's why kings traditionally wore purple. Priests, purple. It's a sign of royalty and wisdom. But I'm careful even doing this too much, because it is a rather dark color. And I noticed that, especially with my chemistry of my body, I am prone to get depression. I don't do this too much, because it can lead to that. I will sometimes, then I'll counter it with another meditation of a lighter color. But that's a little warning I wanted to give to you now too. So you anoint it, you bring it to you. I also use, when I really want to manifest magic or manifest a creation in my life, I will also use sigils at the same time. I do that because I know sigils work. I will spend some time doing my candle, meditating on my sigil, and doing my breathing. And then I will light my candle. I light it. Now what you're doing is, after you put that desire mentally into that candle, and you didn't really put in the candle, remember, I'm going to keep saying that. It's in your mind. In your mind now you have a candle burning, and it's representing your desire that you brought to you. This is a physical tool to visualize it. Now you light that candle, and you leave it alone. Now I don't mean specifically that you leave it in a alone. It's in a safe place, but you don't mess with it. You don't think about it. You let your desire get released into the universe, because you cannot have it come back to you and manifest that energy if with your thoughts you keep bringing it back to you. You keep thinking about it, what you wanted. If you notice, the most potent magic happens when you say something with lots of emotion. Like I told you with the story of my children, I had a tremendous amount of emotion, and I went into my room by myself. You know, because I would never do that in front of them. I just had it. I went to my room. I released a tremendous amount of emotion, wishing that I had solitude, wishing that I was at peace and I didn't have this problem. I released it, and then it was gone. Didn't think about it. Well, 2 weeks later, it manifested my life. You gotta release it, though. And that was a negative thing that I released. You have to be careful, and like I said, with your desires and your thoughts. But if you don't release it, you keep thinking about it, you're drawing it back to you. If you're doubting, I wonder if it's working, you're going to experience a state of it possibly not working. And that's haphazard magic. That's not what you want. Okay, I've already said that. You just leave it alone, you release what you put into it, and you let it go. I'm also going to tell you I don't care about the stigma or the propriety of some people. I also use tantric practices. Now, that tantric practices do not mean that you use sexual energy to the point of orgasm. That's not what tantric practices mean. It means that you use you stimulate or use sexual energy to bring that energy into your body. Now, the more energy you have, remember, is going to be crystallized in the astral. And so you can use those too. And I haven't used that very often, but there are times where if I really wanted something or desired to have it manifest, I would draw upon those practices too. So you have many practices you can bring into this simultaneously. You can bring the practice of aromatherapy vibration, which stimulates your unconsciousness and brings those things to you. You can use the practice of sigils, which is tapping into your subconscious again. You can use the practice of visualizing your desire, bringing it into the candle, and releasing it through burning. Okay, so the last thing I want to teach you today is this. Again, I want to express to you that time and space, whether you think so or not, they are an illusion. Okay, you have all of your senses that tell you what is around in your environment, and those senses create things in your mind to give you a perspective that give you the illusion of things being outside of yourself. Things are not outside of yourself. I say when you want a desire, you release it to the universe and it comes back to you. I've heard mystics tell me, I've had a few people that were very wise that luckily came through my path. I guess that old adage, when the student is ready, the teacher will come. And so that has happened to me in certain areas. Have told me that it's not as much bringing it out into time and space and having it roam the universe and come back to you. It's not technically what's happening. You have an auric field that surrounds you. And if you imagine your auric field, the reality is it's like an eggshell. And the eggshell has a mirror in the inside. Imagine an eggshell, and you're in the middle of this eggshell, your energy and your soul, your consciousness, and there's a mirror all around the inside of that eggshell. Everything you send out now, because it's a mirror, and you let it go from yourself, is going to be reflected back. That's how things are working with our minds and our senses and our realities. And there is going to come a time, I really believe, in our evolution as a human species and where we are going eventually as souls, where we are going to be able to do things we had no idea that we could do, because our beliefs are going to change, our understanding of quantum realities, of the nature of existence beyond our senses, is going to increase to the point where we understand deeply, our beliefs change, and our reality is reflected in those belief changes. That's already happening, and you are a part of that, and so am I. I'm going to quit. I've told you a lot today. I appreciate you listening. If you are listening, well, I don't appreciate it. I mean, I have to tell you, if you're listening and you've learned something, then that's for you. But I appreciate you receiving it so that I could give it, because then I'm in a state of having, and you're in a state of receiving, and we both benefit. So I'm going to let you go today. Hope you learned something. I'm going to sign off for now. Bye-bye.